I'm just going to try to restart. Wait, nope. Back to 60? Is it going to stay at 60? Yeah, look at that. We're already more frames into the game than we were last time in half the time. Anyway, let's see. Game 1, Tower of Heaven. Pretty neutral stage. Is this that Zelda Absa skin? I have no idea what's going on with that Mage Breaker. That's so frustrating, though. See, I feel like that's the kind of stuff that Chapter should have been looking for a little more last time. Just pop them up with, like, pop them towards you with the cloud and then follow up with anything. Because it's such a good setup. Alright. Easy up tilt up air. Hold faith. Oh, what was that, DI? Ew. Not bueno. The particle effect on this Abyss Setter skin is really interesting. Okay, that was better DI. Because with the same kind of, like, with the same DI quality, that definitely would have been another stock gun for White Kevin. Let's see. Up tilt again. Yep. Seems like compared to Chapter, White Kevin really understands, like, how to punish things better. Dead as hell. Get out. I don't know. I definitely like the downer usage here. That was... could have been done a lot faster. Ibe is being pretty much better than Kevin at connecting hits, like, quick, quick, quick. But at the same time, I think White Kevin is killing a little more efficiently. If only a little. Okay, then. That was actually a really fast game. I suppose Zeta versus Apsa should usually be pretty fast, unless the Apsa is, like, camping super hard. Let's see, what's this? Game 2? Tempest? Another weird counter pick. I mean, I guess the stage is, like, a little bit better than, I definitely like the stage more than I like the FD pick last set from Chapter, but it's still not really something I would want to choose against Zetterburn's Absa, because, like, I don't want to give this character more ways to recover. I don't like those platforms being there off stage because it just means that he gets so many more ways to just get back. Okay. DI looking kind of suboptimal in this set. It seems like White Kevin, so far anyway, has been applying what I was talking about with the platform stuff a little bit better. Like, when you're on fire, just don't fight Zetterburn. Get out of there. Because, like, Absa's biggest weakness is that, like, she's kind of light and not that good framed at it, right? So, when you're, like, in risk of dying even earlier than usual, just don't. Okay, never mind. I take back everything what I said. Everything about what I said about him doing better. Because that was, like, exactly what I was criticizing Chapter 4 earlier. Can't get... nope, too high to connect that now. Now we're in that fun Absa territory where you have to, like, get link a hit off a cloud to kill. That'll do it. I probably would have gone for an up smash there, but just the same. I guess that was probably a lot cooler. Can't quite get the ping pong combos on deck, but close enough. I definitely don't like how Ibe just, like, ran up and stopped there. I guess he might have been, like, trying to fish out a parry, but the parry just didn't come out. Huh, I wonder if he DI'd down to fall out of that or what. Ah, yeah. We've entered true Absa territory. It doesn't feel great when you're just, like, kind of flittering around off stage as Absa like that and not really getting anything done with it. Yo, is Ibeevil gonna bring this back? Like, he's actually even the gap super hard here. Oh, jump straight into that. Never mind. No gaps here, son. Once again, my FPS is just dropping randomly. Why? Edelus, help! Can I get into this game without the FPS lagging? No. What on earth? Rivals, please. It's not that hard to run. Come on. You know what, while I wait for it to drop back to normal, I'm going to actually... Rivals of Aether, FPS drops. Okay. Oh snap, we're back to 60, let's go. I do blame Dan. Anyway. Guess we're going to Fire Capital here, another neutral, I believe. I guess Ivy's just going with the thematic counter pick instead of something. Or maybe White Kevin banned in List of Best. If that's even the stage that Ivy would prefer. I don't know. I haven't played Ivy in so long. I haven't played this game in so long. In part because I get random FPS drops. With my 1080 Ti. I have no idea if I have some sort of e-sync thing going on. That's probably what the issue is, but... Good parry there. And then he goes for... I don't know. Like, an up smash might have killed there. If not, like, a back air up smash 100% would have. He definitely could have optimized that parry punish a little bit better. I guess it doesn't matter because he gets the kill without taking any more damage anyway, but... I don't know. Like, he could have just ended this game a couple seconds faster if he wins, you know? Gets kicked in the face. Get out of here. I didn't even recognize that, like, Kevin was on fire there. It's actually so hard to see with this Abyss skin. Get out of there, Absa, get out of there! Let's see, can he close this out? He's almost definitely going to be able to... Or he can just stand there and wait, I guess. Interesting. Okay. I feel like a lot of what White Kevin's doing wrong is just fucking standing still. Because I feel like he does it way more than he should and it's not really working out for him. Forward air. Yo, that was slick. I also really, I don't like how IB just keeps spamming out that side B. Want me to hop on Discord commentary? Sure! Like I said, I'm just sitting in the DRX one now. Buddy, how's it going? Wow, you are super quiet in here.
Am I just, like, really quiet?
I just doubled your volume, so you should be good now.
The thing is that